Kevin for you.
Congregation, I welcome you for this wonderful arts event. It's great to have Professor Al Bright from Youngstown State University here painting and to be able to be part of the whole creative process. Seeing an artist paint is just a wonderful opportunity for us. But also to have live jazz music here at Beaver Falls is also a real treat. And so we are grateful that Nathan Davis and company have joined Professor Bright here this evening. This is a great treat. We welcome all of you. If you're not familiar with the layout here at Christ Church, if you need the restrooms, they're in the narthex, the women's room on that end, the men's room on that side. Following the happening this evening, the event, downstairs, one level, we have our art display from the local artists, and there's some student work here from Youngstown State University. We invite you to come down and view the art that's on exhibit, and there's also refreshments, a lovely buffet that the women and parishioners have put forth. So please stay and greet our artists, both our musicians and our painter. This is a real treat for us. At this time, I will turn the microphone over to Professor Bright, and he will give you a little more illumination into what we're going to experience here this evening.
Thank you very much, Reverend. First, I'd like to thank Nathan Davis and his company for joining me on this in this experience. Nathan Davis is one of the world's greatest saxophonists and recording artists. He is Dr. Nathan Davis from the University of Pittsburgh, where he directs the jazz studies program there. He's accompanied by terrific giants in jazz. I'm going to let him introduce his group. But they're all doctors and professors at the University of Pittsburgh in the Pittsburgh area, and also outstanding recording artists. So I'm very honored to have an opportunity to work with them. We're working a la prima. We have never played together or rehearsed. This is all improvisational and spontaneous. I'm going to attempt to paint to the rhythms and express the color in their music. This is a very rare experience because oftentimes the spectator does not have an opportunity to see the creative process and to see the work actually being created or invented. We oftentimes see the byproduct of this experience in the gallery. But you'll have an opportunity tonight to participate in this creative experience. You're going to have an aesthetic experience, hopefully. I'm going to have a creative experience. I cannot have the same experience as you because I can't gain enough psychological distance away from the process to be objective. I'm going to be subjective in terms of my interpretation and expression. But there's going to come a moment in time when all of us are going to feel the energy coming to a completion in the work. Your feelings are going to have an impact on what I do. The music is going to have an impact on your feelings. The music's going to have an impact on me. You are going to raise your energy at certain points, and there will be points in the process of creating this work in which you will really feel that the work should be left alone, because there'll be something about the transition or the development here that you may really particularly care for. But I'm going to continue to work through those moments, and you'll see the work live and die. It's like a birth and death process. It's really wonderful that we're doing it here in the church, which is a spiritual temple. because the painting and this whole creative process is going to be very similar to the process of life. It will come to a head, and I may dramatically change it, and it'll have a rebirth again. But ultimately, it's going to end, and it's going to be the culmination of all of our feelings in this room. And I welcome you to participate, to allow your feelings to express, because I need your energy, and I need the energy of the music. So I thank you very much for coming. Sit back and enjoy it, and I hope you'll have a wonderful aesthetic experience with that. I'm painting with oils on canvas. I have no prescribed notion as to what is going to occur. I'm going to start breaking that white surface and introducing shapes and form and color. I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Nathan Davis, who will introduce this group.
Thank you. So happy to be here. I was just speaking to the minister earlier about what I think is the positive side of the program. I think that there's a long history of that. In fact, I related to him that in the 55, when I went to Chicago and played, we used to rehearse in the basement of that time, I think, the Lutheran Church with a big band, jazz big band. It was about 3,700 block, 3,500 block, something like that, on South Park. At that time, that was really something that was brand new. People weren't used to that, taking jazz to church. In fact, when I grew up as a kid in Kansas City, you didn't do that. You didn't mix the two. And then I think I mentioned to you that I had done a program like this also in Paris. I used to live in Paris. Painters from different countries, from Sweden and Germany, you know, different countries, and musicians from different countries. We did it live at the ORTF. That was interesting. Actually, I've done one here in the States also with Al. He almost forgot about that. I reminded him. That was, 70s or something?
Yes, in the early 70s.
Yeah, we did one. It was kind of impromptu. But this is the first time we're doing it. This particular group, and of course for you. We hope you'll enjoy it, and we'll try to not let the music be too live. You do have a very lively church here, so we'll try not to be too live. But it is important we support what Al is doing, so therefore, I may turn my back, I will in fact turn this way so we're actually watching, and we have certain songs we're going to play, but it's going to be continuous, and I'm going to actually try to conduct and change and go along with him too, so it's improvisation in both parts. For instance, if we're playing a song, and I would like to play it, Body and Soul, we may change that right in the middle if I see him going in another direction. So the whole thing is improvisation. But we hope you'll get the spirit. We have the spirit. Remember, it's all God's music. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. so much, Nathan.
Yeah. I'd like to say we have Greg Humphries on the drum there. Let's thank him.
Consummated. And I will call it harmonic conversion, because I think that's what was happening in the room in terms of spirits, souls, and love and happiness all coming together to make this piece sing. And I thank you very much for your energy. And I'll be more than happy to entertain any questions you might have before we break up. Yes.
Have you painted to other kinds of music besides jazz?
Yes, I have. I've painted to classical, ballet dancers. I actually painted a composition in a church, a Baptist church, with a minister preaching and a choir playing. I painted to a 125-piece orchestra, did Mahler. I did a composition back in the 70s with a poet reciting The Raven. I did a composition once with teenagers at a conference, and they were doing primal screaming while I painted. So I painted to endless variety of music and performers. But jazz has so much color, and it's improvisational, and it never is the same from one moment to another, because it rises and falls with energy that comes from the group, from the spectators, and it's constantly evolving. Yes?
Are you a musician as well?
I play some jazz flute, but I'm not on the level of dare to step in the stage with this. But I do play jazz flute, and I love it, but it's more of a hobby than a professional thing for me. Any other questions? Well, I thank you very much for coming. Once again, I'd like to have another round of applause for the wonderful music. And thank you, Father, for inviting us and making this all happen. And see you. And special thanks to Celia McKean, who is the coordinator of the arts program here, and actually was the one who called me and made arrangements for this all to come about. Thank you very much.
You are more than welcome to join us downstairs for refreshments and also to view other artists' work from our valley. Thank you for coming this evening.
And feel free to come up and look at the painting up close. The color really will sing when once it gets into a gallery and you see better lighting on it. It'll take about 6 weeks for it to dry. To cure to the touch, it never dries. The oils never dry. But I'm going to leave it here in the church for a few days. You can see it on display downstairs.
Like the universe.
Yes.